Good morning, students. Today we can continue the remaining part of this chapter. Today's class starts with three domain system means it is dealing with the introduction of domain system in taxonomy. Okay, it's a different category. Then where is its place, where we are giving that domain? It comes above the place of kingdom in that hierarchy is their kingdom, phylum, class, then that hierarchy is there. In that hierarchy, this domain system comes above the kingdom. Okay, and it is introduced by Karl Voss in 1990. Next, that three domains are bacteria, archaea, and eukarya. And regarding that bacteria and archaea, they all include prokaryotes. Then what's the difference exists between this bacteria and archaea? Bacteria is the most primitive, small, and having peptidoglycan in its cell wall. At the same time, archaea is complex, and it is somewhat similar to eukaryotes. And also in their case, their cell wall lack peptidoglycan. That's the difference between bacteria and archaea. That's why they are put in different domains. It also means that archaea evolved a long pass from bacteria. Then taxonomic hierarchy. Hierarchy, it is an order of arrangement. What is taxonomical hierarchy? It is a grade of status or rank, one above the other. Why we are creating such status? For convenience, for what? For classifying organisms conveniently, we developed a grade of status. That grade of status is called the taxonomical hierarchy. And then the first established popular hierarchy is Linnaean hierarchy, and it's telling in this point, this is the first hierarchical system developed by Carl Linnaeus in 18th century, and it is published in the 10th edition of Systema Naturae by Carl Linnaeus in 1958. In the book published by Carl Linnaeus, mention about the hierarchical system of classification. So that's why that classification is again called as Linnaean hierarchy. Next, we are going to see that hierarchy. Its peculiarity is that it starts from most general to most similar. What's that it means? Most general means first category includes so much of organisms having many different characters, and from there it is more confining, and when it is lower most category or level, that category is included by more similar or closest organisms. This is what it starts from most general and ends by most similar. In the initial time, it consists of five hierarchy levels. Which are they? They are class, order, genus, species, and varieties. And later, with the advent of more organisms, after the discovery of more organisms, it creates some problem in classifying them. Then add additionally two more levels, that are family and phylum. Family is added by Bichli, and phylum is added by Haeckel in this respective years. And at the same time, that variety is discarded. This level is discarded. In the current system of courts, seven basic categories exist. Which are the seven basic categories? It's a kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. These are the seven basic categories. This is the most familiar system also. Most familiar system of hierarchy used in classification, classifying organisms. Seven categories. This order you need to by heart. Kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. As the identification of more and more diverse organism with these seven basic categories, it become difficult to classify the identified organisms. So again, some subdivisions are developed. That subdivisions, I am going to see that subdivisions, how the subsections are formed. That subsections are identified or may distinguish by adding some prefixes. Which prefixes? Super, sub, and infra. Here in this picture, we can see that phylum chordata. Then again, subphylum means again new organisms, animals have identified. They need to correctly classify and placed in distinct criteria. For that purpose, it emerged very necessary to add some additional levels by giving some prefixes. Sub, then infra class, that comes under subclass, below the subclass. This is the additional levels. So in your textbook also, including this additional level, a hierarchy is given that is having, I think 20. Let me see that. It's with 21 levels. So that much deep we can create that hierarchy for properly identifying or classifying a identified organism. Okay, next, components of classification. Mainly three components are there: category, taxon, and rank. Then we are going to see what each one. Category means what? Category means all these levels are actually called category. Kingdom is a category, phylum is a category, class is a category, order is a category, family, like that. So it is an abstract term. Abstract term means that term has no life, but the organism placed inside that level are only concrete objects. Example, there's a kingdom, phylum, class, order, like that. Then what is taxon? Taxon means whatever group of organisms with its common ancestor included in a category are called taxon. Example, I will make it more clear. Family, takes the case of family. Family consists of group of organisms sharing some similar properties. That organisms are called a taxon. Okay, group of organisms with a common ancestor placed in a definite category of hierarchy classification is taxon. Example, arthropoda, mammalia, they are all classes. Class arthropoda, class mammalia, they are all classes. And each classes exists a definite group of organisms having certain common characters. So that group of organisms are called taxon. And then the main task of taxonomist, what is the main task? To assign that taxa, that group, to the correct category. And the most related species are included. Related species are included in genera. Then what includes in species are very, very closely related interbreedable type comes under species. Related generated family. Then most related species comes in genus. And the most related genus comes under family. Most related families comes under order. Most related orders form the classes. Most related classes form phylum. And most related phylums form the kingdom. Okay. Mainly two kingdom, plant kingdom, animal kingdom. Okay. Ranks. And what is rank? That we need to understand very clearly. I will explain you. every organism, each and every organism, we consider whatever small or big organism, that organism belong to a species category. And that species is included in a higher genus level. And also that genus level itself is included in a higher family level. And that family level itself is included in a higher order level. So, okay, in more clear way, we can understand it in this form. Rank. Look at this picture. This is first rank, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Then if we take, I will explain with an example. Example, taxa, mammalia and apes. These both terms, these both group will get the same rank. Why they get the same rank? These two are mammalia, the term mammalia and the term apes. They both are classes. So, they both will get the same rank. We rank from bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both mammalia and apes get the same rank, that is 5. Similarly, one more example is given here. Panthera tigris sumatrae is a lower rank than the Panthera tigris because the former is a subspecies. Panthera tigris sumatrae. Three terms are here. It should be written in italics. It's a mistake. It comes in a lower rank than which one? Panthera tigris. Why? Because Panthera tigris sumatrae is lower. It's a subspecies of Panthera tigris. So, these two, Panthera tigris and Panthera tigris sumatrae, have different ranks. I think it's clear to you. Then how organisms are arranged in taxonomy? Regarding the species. Species is the fundamental unit of taxonomy. It's basic. When we come up to the level of species, that means we clearly identified an organism. And it consists of closely related interbreeding organisms. Then genus means what? Genus means many species that share common features come under genus. Example, genus Equus. Genus Equus, it includes species like Equus gabellus, Equus azinus, Equus zebra. All these come under this genus. But basically they are different species. Family also like that. Similar genera joined to form family. Likewise, similar family related joined to form order. Closely related order form next class. Closest to class means more related class forms the phylum. Related phylum form kingdom. Then we are coming to nomenclature, means naming. Nomenclature, that idea is first developed by Carlos Linnaeus. And he is the man behind the binomial nomenclature. International code. Code means stipulations, regulations, rules. That is the meaning of code. International code of zoological nomenclature. That idea is first given by Hugh E. Strickland. The person is a British ornithologist, bird learner. Then zoologist and paleontologist. And there are mainly three codes in nomenclature. Codes means three levels, three distinct fields of naming. Rules, rule sets are there. Which are the three different rules centers? They are International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. It is for it contains rules for naming all protozoans and metazoans animals. Then next one, International Code of Botanica Nomenclature. Botanical nomenclature, that L moves apart. It means it contains all the rules for naming plants, fungi and algae. International Code of Nomenclature of Bacteria means it contains all the rules to name bacteria and cyanobacteria. Which body is regulating? Regarding the International Code of Zoological Nomenclature, it is regulated by International Commission on Zoological Nomenclature. That rules first edition published in 1961. This last edition come out in 1999. And that code determine which name is valid for a taxon. And that decision is not taken by a single scientist, instead of a commission consists of many zoologists. So next code, regarding that code, each code is consists of many articles and recommendations. And this code will not regulate the names of taxa above the family. That family, I think it comes to your mind that family means it's a category in the hierarchy, and through this code we cannot regulate names when onwards above family and also below the rank of subspecies. When on reaching these two level, these two level is not regulatable through this codes. Principles of nomenclature. Fundamental goal is to ensure stability and universality. Universality means that name should be universal. There should be only a single name for one organism. Three basic rules are there. Priority, homonymy, preservation of well-established names. These are the three basic rules. What is priority? Let's see that. Priority means it states first name. Whatever the first name given to the taxa, that is more valid irrespective to how much it is described, how much it is clear. So whatever the first name, that is more prior, that's more important. That's the rule states, and that rule comes out in 1st January 1758. What's the main drawback of that rule? Drawback is, even if whatever the name is poor or incompletely described, even though we need to consider it as valid because it is very old. Then homonymy. Homonymy means sometimes, because of any cause, if same names came for two or more taxa, it may create ambiguity. Ambiguity means it's not clear. It may results in confusion. That should avoid. For avoiding that, that is this principle. Name should be unique. Then preservation of well-established name means for preserving stability and universality in zoological nomenclature. That preservation of well-established names. If any such well-established names are there for organisms, that we need to preserve. Don't replace that name with any other words. So through that role, it protects the replacement of well-established names given to organisms. Then main themes of nomenclatures accepted by ICZN. They are uninormal nomenclature. Uninormal nomenclature means only one name is there. When onwards that practice starts, taxons above subgenera, subgenera onwards, there is only one name, no two names. When onwards, above subgenera onwards, then and that name itself, it is singular for genus and subgenus. For genus and subgenus. Okay. And plural names came for those taxa above genus. For genus and its subdivision, that is subgenus, singular nouns are used. Plural nouns are used for those taxa or that levels above genus. Binomial is already taught to you. Binomial means consists of two names, genus and species name. First letter is generic name, should start with a capital letter, and all the letters should be in italics. Example, Homo sapiens. Advantage of binomial nomenclature is that that organs, a particular organism, will have the same name in all language, and it is unique and it is internationally adopted. Means that binomial nomenclature is internationally adopted in botany, zoology, and bacteriology. Trinomial nomenclature also we learned already learned. Means three names are there. When it happens, if the species is again further classified to subspecies. Example, Columbia, Libia, Domestica. In that, Domestica is subspecies.